HubSpot has a lot of features, and a lot of them cost more money than you might have today. So how do you know what to budget for? Let's talk about just that.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
If you're considering HubSpot or you already use a portion of HubSpot, maybe you just use a free CRM, there are a lot of things to consider when you're budgeting for a tool like this. It goes without saying that a lot of times we get involved with a software tool and we have this initial expense and then, oh, there's an upgrade around the corner and, oh, this costs more and this costs more. So rather than being surprised, let's walk through the different modules and what to expect of each because it is important to budget for the future. So we're going to use my whiteboard here with my lovely drawings, but we're going to talk about these three different modules and the pricing that comes along with each of these. So from the get-go, HubSpot has the CRM, the marketing, and the service module. So a lot of people come in here on the free CRM because it is. It's just that. It's free. And now they have a marketing free and a service free as well. So you can get a ton of value out of that tool. You can get things like manage all of your contacts, and you can have live chat on your website, again, for the cost of $0 for the tool. So this is the HubSpot pricing as it exists today. We're recording this video in September of 2019. So if you're watching this later, you know, some of these things are subject to change. For example, sales professional is actually going to go up in price in November. So anything that goes up in price, you probably want to consider if you want to buy it now. But from a structure standpoint, they've got four levels. So free, starter, professional, and enterprise. So each one of these modules is priced individually so that if you need that functionality, you can add it in at the level that makes sense for your company. So in this video, I can't or I won't go into all of the specific detail of each one of these levels because it's just far too much. But if you want specific details down to the what's included, what it looks like, why you might need it, head over to Simple Strat's blog. We'll have a comment or a note in the comments below with a link to send you over to that blog so you can get all the details and figure out maybe how to budget and what's best for you and how to price all of that out. Again, keep in mind that you're working with a company that has, you know, sales reps, or if you buy through an agency like Simple Strat, there's also probably some negotiation you can build in there as well. Not guaranteed, but you know, sometimes you can luck out on that. So most people start with these free tools if they're new to the HubSpot platform and new to marketing automation and marketing tools altogether. You don't get some of those really powerful automation features that HubSpot is known for by having these free tools. What you do get in there is if you're using something like, let's say, MailChimp, and you want to have your CRM sync with your email marketing, you'll get that inside of the marketing tool. You're just going to be limited by 2,000 email sends. At least that's what it is at the moment. When MailChimp first started, that's how they also limited you, was a certain number of email sends. I think now they have similar things in play to then get you to upgrade depending on what their packages are. So get all of your data into that one system. Make sure that you're managing that with your chat. You get live chat for free inside of the service hub for $0. You have that marketing send. You're also getting free tools like the prospects tool and the ability to build lists inside of HubSpot. When you get to the starter version, that's going to give you a little bit more flexibility, more email sends. You're going to have more things like call tracking inside of the service hub. And then you're going to have inside of the sales starter, you're going to have sequences. If you're not sure what sequences are, head over to one of our other videos and learn about the power of sequences. When you get to professional, you're going to have things like unlimited templates that you can use from a sales standpoint inside the sales tool. You do get that marketing automation that you think of when you think of marketing automation inside of HubSpot. Workflows and if person A does this, then all of these things cascade to happen. That's what you get inside of marketing professional. You also get a multitude of integrations that come with that, or the ability to integrate. And then inside of service professional, you have things like knowledge center and some of those pieces that come that give you more flexibility and how to better serve your customers. Now inside of enterprise, you're going to have a large organization. You're not going to be limited by the number of contacts. That is a key thing to keep in mind. Each one of these tiers has a limit on number of contacts, and then you're simply just billed for the additional contacts that you have above that threshold. So that's how that billing works. Now, if you're thinking of getting all of these together, definitely check out HubSpot's growth pricing because they have growth packages. I'm assuming you're gonna use all these tools together, and there's usually different pricing with that. So it's a little bit of a jungle if you're looking at HubSpot, you know, as a new tool. It can be difficult to understand the pricing. So again, head over to that blog post over on Simple Strat. comment or a link in the video below to figure out more about the pricing. And if you have questions, if you're just thinking, I don't really know what package that I need or what capabilities I need now and how that relates to the features that are in HubSpot, go ahead and drop us a comment. We'll be happy to follow up with you and help answer any of those questions that you might have. So that was it for today. For more tips, tricks, and how-tos on HubSpot, hit that subscribe button. And if you have any questions, again, drop us a comment and we'll be sure to address them in a future video.